think he's seen some holes in Roberto Luongo the last five-plus periods.
Agreed. Marchand penalty.
Oh, man. Oh, there's a little more there.
You knew this was coming. You knew this was coming. And that's Ballard on Marchand. They better look out, because if McQuaid gets going, he can just devastate. I think that's ear off he has right now. He'll destroy him. See him turtle? McQuaid is one tough hombre.
You got to be careful in the last 5 minutes of a game. You get called with an instigator, you're not going to be around for the next game.
Oreskovich wants to go with him. I don't think a lot of guys know how tough Adam McQuaid is. He's heavy duty.
It is the time now for cooler heads. McQuaid is going to be ushered off by the linesman. 2:27 to go in the third, so he must have more than just a minor here.
The penalty here by Brad Marchand. But I don't like this play right here. He sees Daniel Sedin coming, and he submarines him, and that is a dangerous, dangerous play, and I love what Keith Ballard does in this situation.
I'm with you. But Marchand's a tricky cat. He knows what's coming. And I'm with you. I don't like that at all. But again, he plays on the edge all the time. This is clearly a penalty.
Yeah, that's a penalty. The free hand, no question.
And then this one, he knows it's coming.
That is dangerous.
Yes, it is.
When a player decides he's going to go low, when a player's going to try to come in, because there's no give. And it's a good thing it probably was Daniel Sedin there, Pierre, because he wasn't going in there with any speed and really any intent to really hammer Brad Marchand. If that's somebody else that plays on an edge, they're coming in with a little bit more of a rate of speed, and then that player's going, he's going to be doing a cartwheel right over the back of Marchand.
If that's Rafi Torres, that's a different deal.
You could get seriously, seriously hurt when a player does that.